Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of our Farming RPG series. With our NPC event system in place, we'll take a little detour to touch up on the overall user experience in our game. To that end, we got some new sprites and gave our panels and buttons a fresh coat of paint. As usual, we imported the sprites and changed the settings accordingly so that it can be used in our UI. To prevent the sprites from being squished, we adjusted the borders of each sprite in the sprite editor. And with that, we are ready to replace our assets. For everything else to fall in line with the look, we updated the item sprite as well. You guys have been asking for this for a long time, so we are finally getting to it. Working animations for the player. We took watering and plowing animations over from Mixamo and got right to work. In the same manner we did the animations the last time, when we import them, we have to configure the rig settings and so forth. After configuring them accordingly, we set up the transitions. We threw the two new animations in the animator, and then we created another two animation triggers, and called them watering and plowing. And then we created the transition arrows and set them up accordingly. To have the watering can fit properly in the player's hand, we need to drag the watering can to be a child of the hand point in the hierarchy. And then we adjust its transform so that it fits properly. And then we set watering as the default state in the animator. Then after that we did this by trial and error. We entered play mode and just paused during the animation sequence to make further adjustments. We just have to copy the transform component of our changes. We exit play mode and paste it. And then we repeat the same for the whole tool. Over in the player interaction script, we got the animations to trigger based on what the player is holding.
For the animator and equipment logic, we created variables for the animator and equipment data, and we referenced the animator component within the start function. In the interact function, we added references to the equip tool and set up a switch case for the hole and watering can. We set the idle animation as the default state and then tested each tool's animations. To avoid accidental use when clicking out of the inventory, we removed mouse 0 as the alternate interact button.
Now that we have the animations that can play, we need the player to hold the items when executing them. Hence, we made a new script, Anim Events Tools, to accomplish this.
Created variables for two game object types per tool. one for the original model and one for an instantiated clone. We created additional public functions for spawning and despawning each tool. And then we converted each tool to a prefab variant and removed them from the hierarchy.
These functions will be called with the playing of the animations.
We assign the components to each prefab. And in the plowing animation timeline, we added an animation event that spawns the hole at the start and despawns it at the end. We repeated this for the watering animation, and we tested the animations to ensure smooth tool interactions.
Thus far, our player has been able to work with unlimited stamina, but we want to put a cap to that. First, let's represent the stamina over in the HUD.
We imported the stamina UI and configured it to be like the other UI elements. We added a new image game object, anchored it to the top left, and inserted the stamina base. We made a child image under the stamina base for the stamina emoticon.
Then, we added stamina to the player stats. We created methods to modify its value, and added it to the load and save functions.
We made a static integer for stamina, and we added it to the load stats function. And the function tracks stamina usage, and we also made another function to fully restore stamina when the player sleeps.
After that, we set up the UI representation, and updated it in UI Manager.
And every time there is a change, we call the change stamina UI, which is within the render player stats. For now, we made it so that any tool costs 2 stamina, and we made it so that the stamina updates correctly in the save state script. In our UI manager script, we assigned each stamina emoticon in the inspector. And within Game State Manager, we call Restore Stamina within the Sleep function, making sure that the player regains full stamina upon resting.
That's it for today's part. Hope you enjoyed it. Once again, thank you to all our patrons for supporting the channel, and we will see you next time.